again, we want to thank Sergeant Joseph. I want to publicly thank Sergeant Alexander, Senior Superintendent Martinez. We want to thank Sergeant Nobby and from Shagunas. We want to thank Corporal Liverpool. You know, want to publicly thank them. They have decided to weed out the criminal, the rogue elements, and they have promised that once we pass information to them, we will, you know, they will act on it. You know, they will do their part. Ladies and gentlemen, a couple of days ago, a gentleman came to us and, you know, we started a sting operation. And as a result of that, an acting corporal, 32 years of service in the police service, he was caught. It's alleged that he took $1,000 bribe. He was, you know, he was charged. He appeared before the magistrate in Chagone. I think he's on $100,000 bail. But it is so sad. What you're about to see is unbelievable. But this is a wake-up call. And again, wake-up call for all those in all those police officers, even in Freeport, who have intentions of, we are not going to take it. If you know about government ministries, government ministers who are taking bribe for contract and whatnot, get in contact with us, please. Also, again, Firearms Training Institute, they have now got, there's a paid ad, Firearms Training Institute of Shagunas, John and Henry Street has now gotten Remington cartridges, 12-gauge and 16-gauge. So all hunters with who have their FUL, all right, and legal, you can go to Firearms Training Institute to get your Remington cartridges, 12 and 16 gauge ammunition. Okay, so director, let's go straight to that clip.
I have two
or for your arrest.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And now I come and meet him. I want to come and meet him. We go for something because the people are not bouncing, but they're not in cops.
Mm-hmm. So if you give him how much money?
$1,000 and if the matter go discussion.
So he asked you for $1,000?
Yeah, he said I'll bring $1,000 my brother.
So you always, yeah, so you and your brother are going to meet him today?
No, my brother, I'm okay.
But this policeman from Kunopia wants $1,000 from
yeah,
the trouble the matter.
Yeah, he said,
is he the investigating officer?
I don't know. Yeah, because my brother, you know, the police, and two police come yesterday, my mom know them and my daughter know them. You just see them look at that.
But this policeman called and said he'd give $1,000.
Yeah, he had the warrant.
He has the warrant?
He had the two warrant for my arrest.
Okay, call him now. And put your phone on speakerphone.
Me and other voices on speaker.
Yes, sir.
Three. Yeah. And two.
Okay.
Come on in. But here is the money. So what to do now? My brother tell me only you want to come, but you're afraid to lock up. I could come and give him call, make some arrangement and give the money somewhere else. I'm afraid to come in the station too now. Anywhere you want. Anywhere you want. Huh? I struggle on us. Huh? Are they struggling on us right now? I could meet you by the bank. Yeah, I'll go back to work. Okay. Not too good. I'm afraid to come up the way. I'll give the money. Okay then, I will come and give the money. I'm frightened to come up the way too, but... We have about half an hour to according to the traffic.
And what
Okay, well, if you had to arrest me, I'll not bring the money for you and you had to arrest me. Well, if I had to arrest me, I'll bring Okay, then. I'll go talk to my brother too and see if I get some money.
Alright.
Alright, I'll come down. Alright, I'll come down.
So, we think I'm serial numbers front or back.
$700, but I called somebody to bring the next $300 for me now.
Yeah.
I only have $700, but I called somebody to bring a $300 for me now.
You want to come in
here, sir? No, well, I come in again, I short that $300, so I'm trying to bring it.
You come in
the station,
right?
No, and this time I will come to somewhere else.
You
want to
come in
the
station?
No, me, I want to come in the station.
All right,
well, I just show you, sir, we tell somebody to bring the next $300 for me. They're coming from lunch back to bring the $300. Which one didn't show on us? Which one didn't show on us? Alright. But you go call me and let me know which one then.
Alright.
We had to go lunch back to get the money.
Fed up of corruption in the police service. There are people out there who must pay a bribe to get justice, and that must stop. I mean, this is a poor man who it is alleged that a warrant has been issued for him, but never, as he said, policeman has indicated that he will collect something on his side to see how we can pacify the charges or whatever. So we are on our way to the quick shop, and we'll see what's going to happen from there. Hello? Right. What happened is that we contacted Sergeant Alexander, and a lot of people have been asking me, why did you contact somebody outside of Shagona's? Well, to be honest with you, this guy with 32 years service, I got the impression that he would have, known a lot of people, and a lot of people would have known him. So just go into any officer. But then it was brought to my attention by senior officer in Shagona's that they didn't care, they would have gone for him. And hats off to Sergeant Alexander from Task Force, and Alexander been working with us very closely. Also, Sergeant, Senior Superintendent Martinez, that's the guy who's investigating the rope officers right now. As you know, we liaise with him very closely also. Om Lala was also part of the operation. He was just telling us illegal, making sure we play it on the legal part, and then hats off to him again. We didn't just set up a Vike operation. As you can see, the suspect has just gotten into the car, He's there chatting with the guy. You saw him. Now, what we did, we made the guy open the trunk and as an indication that that would have been a signal and, pretend that his car was, down with the radiator or something like that. But then again, we want to thank again. I'm thanking these officers. Hats off to them. Sergeant Nobby, Great guy, Sergeant Alexander. Hats off to these people. Corporal Liverpool, Sergeant Alex. I mean, I can't thank you enough, and all the seniors that were aware of it. I mean, it's very, very sad, and it's a wake-up call. We need to weed it out. I know some officers might want to kill me now and come after me, but I would like them to come. I want them to come. That is why they didn't take the 12,000 bribe in Freeport last time, because we were fully aware of it. When you think we don't know, we know, you know. You might see someone coming to give you a bribe, and you might say, that person don't know Ian Alleyne. You wouldn't believe it. You wouldn't believe it. But, again, go ahead. What you are seeing here is that the suspect is in the vehicle. I mean, he's still chatting with the gentleman. I heard it. He said that we could meet at a popular restaurant. He's coming Chagonas. They were supposed to meet at Busy Corner. He took a taxi from Busy Corner. I mean, this guy was super desperate. He's out of the vehicle now, and as you can see, he's standing. But we had the whole area, cordoned off with CIU officers, sergeant, and also officers from Chagonas. You saw sergeant. He's just been apprehended by Sergeant Alexander. In fact, we brought up Sergeant Alexander in his short pants, because when we were fully aware it was going down. You're seeing Sergeant Joseph there. I'm not seeing Sergeant Nobby or Liverpool, but they were all aware of it. Yeah? Corporal Liverpool, sorry, of Chagonas. And Sergeant Joseph has indicated to me, once we know the corrupt elements, please pass it to them. Okay? And I really want to thank Sergeant Alexander. Really, really want to thank him. He sat down there, I called him out. He came down in a rush here, because I think Senior Superintendent Martinez had called him. They have a lot of confidence in Sergeant Alexander and all those hardworking police officers. Imagine 32 years service going down the drain. Well, you saw it there. Director, was there a free shot? You saw the free shot after the end of the video? Thank you. You saw it, right? Could you just hit back the shot, please? Okay, this is the officer in custody with Sergeant Alexander. Very shameful, shameful picture. It's distasteful. What Alexander had to say?
We are talking about swift justice. When those police officers want to take a bribe, that is what you will get. He described it. I mean, the suspect was taken into custody. How do you describe it?
Utter nonsense.
Two calls. Remember, the run of this program tonight is at 10:30. We're just going to take two calls considering that what you just saw. Just two calls. Take the volume along your set. Hi, good evening. Hello. Go ahead.
Yes, I just have a suggestion, Mr. Alleyne. Fire your cameraman. He's very unprofessional and incompetent.
Well, okay, I wouldn't do that. But you know why I wouldn't do that? He's honest. I might get a professional who might be a big thief and a scam, but my cameraman is honest, all right? And we didn't use a tripod. Let's focus on the issue. Focus on the blasted man being held and taken into custody. Don't focus on my cameraman. At least my cameraman is an honest guy. Hi, good evening. He's faithful and loyal to me. Hi, good evening.
Darling, good evening.
Go ahead.
Program. That guy that you all hold it, I know that guy since I was a little girl as a police officer. And I'm very sorry to know.
I'm sad.
He's like that.
I am sad. Do you know, I didn't know it was him. Only when I reached and I saw him, I was just surprised. Hi, one more caller. One more caller and we're ready to go. Remember, the run of this program is tonight at 10:30. Hi, good evening.
Hi, Mr. Alleyne. Very good work. That man, 32 years, greedy for money. And tell that guy, don't talk about your cameraman. I know your cameraman. He's a good man.
And an honest man.
Perfect.
Thanks again. So good night. And to my cameraman, Russell, Judas, we love you. All right? So don't let nobody embarrass you. You're a good cameraman.